Let's talk about matrices. Now, what is a matrix? A matrix, as it is defined, okay, is basically a set of numbers or a group of numbers that can be written in this form, where A is equals to, okay, and this group of numbers can be organized as rows or into rows and columns. Okay, we can actually label each of these numbers, okay, in this format, where we can say this is A11, A12, all the way until A1n, okay, then A21, A22, all the way until A2n, and going downwards, you can go all the way to AM1. Okay, so what is this M and N? Okay, now before we get into that, you can see that a matrix, okay, has rows and columns, okay, and the rows and columns are numbered from 1 onwards. So this is the first row, this is the second row, all the way down to row M. And in terms of column, you have column 1, column 2, all the way to column N. Okay, so basically, when you have a matrix, okay, you can reference each element in the matrix by the rows and columns. Okay, so rows go from 1, okay, all the way to M. And columns go from 1 all the way to n. As you can see, each element in the array is written in the format of a, x, y, where x refers to the row and y refers to the column. Okay, and another thing that you can also get from the entire array is the size. Okay, the size basically refers to the entire number of elements that you have, and that is given by M by N, number of rows multiplied by number of columns. So the M and N is the final or the total number of rows and total number of columns. Now let's look at an example to see how we can apply this. So I have a matrix here, which has elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. As you can see, I have two rows. So row 1 and row 2. These are the rows. And I have two rows and three columns. Okay, so these are three columns. Okay. And the columns are column 1, column 2, and column 3. So in terms of writing the size of this array, you can write that this array is 2 by 3. It's always the number of rows by the number of columns. Okay. Now, there are a few different variations to how a matrix can actually look like. Okay, you can have a matrix, okay, that just has elements like this, whereas you can see I have three rows, 1, 2, and 3, and one column. Okay, in this case we can write this as 3 by 1. Okay, and since there is only a single column, we define this matrix as a column matrix. Okay, so this is one of the matrices that you can see. The other is the case where you have only a single row and multiple columns. Okay, so example, if I have an array where the elements are arranged in this order, then I say I have one row and three columns. Okay, so in terms of the size, we can say this is 1/3. Okay, and since it has only a single row, we call this a row matrix. Okay, so we have column matrix and we have row matrix. Okay, we can also have what we call a zero matrix. Okay, a zero matrix is where all the elements in it are zero. Okay, so for example, K is equals to 0 0 0 0 0. So this is a zero matrix where all the elements in it are zero. You can also have another variation, which is what we call a square matrix. Okay, a square matrix has the same number of rows and columns. Okay, for example, if I write these elements 3, 7, 2, 8, okay, as you can see, I have a total of 2 rows and 2 columns. So this is 2/2. This is a 2/2 matrix. So since the number of rows and the number of columns are the same, we call it a square matrix. Of course, you can grow this square matrix. Okay, instead of just having 2/2, you can also have 3/3 or 4/4 and so on. Okay, so as an example, 1, 5, 7, 2, 4, 6, 3, 1, 8. So as you can see here, I have a matrix with 3 rows and 3 columns. Okay, so this is a 3/3 square matrix. Okay, then you can also have what is known as the diagonal of a square matrix. The diagonal of a square matrix is defined as, okay, so maybe I write it down here first. A diagonal is from the top left hand corner, okay, all the way to the bottom right hand corner. Now if I look at this 2/2 square matrix, the top left hand corner is this number 3, okay, all the way to the bottom right hand corner, which is 8. So the diagonal is 3, 8. Okay, similarly here I can have the diagonal as 1, 4, 8. Okay, so given any square matrix, the diagonal of it is refers to all the elements from the top left hand corner to the bottom right hand corner. Okay, so this leads us to another type of matrix known as the diagonal matrix. In a diagonal matrix, okay, what you have is only elements in the diagonal positions as non-zero and everything else would be zero. Okay, or put it simply, the numbers that are valid are only in the diagonal locations, and every other location the numbers are zero. Alright, so for example, I can say that it is 7, 9, 1, and everywhere else is 0. So this is an example of a diagonal matrix. Okay, and if in the diagonal space, in the diagonal locations here, if all the values here are ones, then we call it a identity matrix. Okay, identity matrix. So in identity matrix, how does it look like? It is exactly the same as any normal square matrix, except that the diagonal locations all have a value of 1. okay, and everywhere else the value is 0. Okay, so that is what we call an identity matrix. Okay, with that we have covered the basics of matrices. In our next few videos, we'll be discussing many of the operations on matrices, such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, and the inverse of matrices. Okay, so do check out those videos to get a much more better understanding on matrix principles. Thank you. Bye.